Hey, Ellie. Want to move over this way? Thank you. Isn't that crazy? You can tell it's used. Everything's got a little bit of wear and tear on it. This is my second one I've seen up close. The first one was Ralph Lauren's in 2006 at the Museum of Fine Arts when they had the Ralph Lauren collection. I barely looked at the Ferraris or Bentleys or Mercedes back then. Girls, you can see the gold foil on the inside of the engine bay from here. Remember Doug DeMuro's video on this where he explained how these fold down? This actually folds down to open up the headlights. Well, they're pop down headlights, I guess. Hey, look, sanitizer. Yes, I remember the video, silly, of course. This thing's ridiculous. It's such a crazy car. It's like America's Lamborghini Countach, basically. The mirrors always just fascinated me, the way they just droop like a dog's ears. It's okay, my bad. Makes it look more like a fighter jet. I mean, it's not as cool as the McLaren F1, but it's one of the coolest cars ever made as far as high performance cars go. I love the styling of it. The aircraft technology and all those weird things. The Gulf colors on this are pretty cool. Oh, it's a... Yeah. God, this thing's crazy. I can't believe we see we're looking at a Vector W8 and a McLaren F1 in the same space. Hi. Oh, I would have paid for you. I didn't know.
Yeah.
No, it's fine. I was just going to pay for you, but I didn't know. Look at that mirror. That's got to be Jay Leno's, right? See how the mirror script looks like a bull? That's kind of in the theme with Lamborghinis from this car going forward. And the doors, when they open up, look like bull horns. I love the eyelashes. I don't like the later ones that got rid of the eyelashes. It's kind of sad when they got rid of them. Look at how close the engine is to your head. This is why this is considered to be like the first supercar. Amelia, look at, come here. From this side? No, like, come here and take a look.
It's got eyelashes.
That's my favorite part. I never liked the later ones that didn't have them.
I know, I can't believe they removed them.
See the center locks? They're red. Look at the other side. They're blue. They're gonna be red on the other side. So it's a directional thing, you understand? So they lock opposite to the direction of travel. So they could, in theory, get a tiny bit loosened when you're going reverse, but never forward.
Back when I was 6 or 7 years old, my father would
I was driving around town with my father, and I had the same problem with my father. He was always in the question of the he quizzed me on as we were driving around, you know, what kind of car is that? And what year is it? And that started this year, 6 or 7 years old. I love cars ever since, even though I couldn't really afford really classic cars like these, but still had a lot of love in cars and always appreciate them.
Do you have a favorite memory?
I guess when I first got my first Porsche, we drove up to New Hampshire together. So my wife and I were two of our kids at the time. We went up to pick up my Porsche. That was in 1966.
You see the CLK? It looks like a production car almost from the outside, except for the wheel flares. There's no back seat or anything. It's pretty extreme. And look, that's a CLK too, technically, even though it's just by name. That's that car right there. Do you see this? The way it's broken down? That's that Mercedes right there. That was inspired, and it was a ripoff of the McLaren F1 in some ways, many ways.
Thank you.
You guys know the whole, like, claim to fame with this one?